Well, state political reporter Liz Daniels joins me now in the studio. Liz, it's been a horror week for Dominic Perrottet.
It has, Georgie, and to think it's only Wednesday. But if Dominic Perrottet is looking to the horizon for blue skies, he won't see them. Not only does he now have to rebuild the party's trust in his political judgment, but he finds himself staring down one of the state's most powerful men in a turf war that puts Sydney's NRL Grand Final under threat.
At Leichhardt Oval, the excitement had been brewing.
But we can build a modern grandstand that goes all the way around the other side of the ground.
But those dreams have been shattered.
We shook on it, we had an agreement, and it's been reneged.
The New South Wales Premier has called the NRL boss's bluff, backflipping on a $250 million promise to upgrade three suburban stadiums.
I'm not accountable to Peter Volandis. I'm accountable to the people of New South Wales.
The immediate fallout, a Sydney Grand Final, is now at risk, with Brisbane ready to pounce.
That decision will be made in the next 2-3 days.
The Premier's excuse has only added to the bad blood.
I have over 1,000 people without a home based on the flooding that we've seen across New South Wales.
To use the human tragedy of the floods to weasel your way out and spin your way out of a commitment takes it to another level.
The losers will be the fans.
It's like turning back the clock when you look around Leichhardt Oval. For nearly 50 years, certainly little has changed. And during that time, government after government have made empty promises while the spiritual home of the Tigers slides into disrepair.
A crowd of up to 18,000 can enjoy old stands, broken toilets.
There are at least 60 games a year that are played here by all different codes.
Across town, the still seething NRL chief was like a dog with a bone.
All we're asking is honour your agreement.
And he may be forced to honour his own. The grand final just 9 weeks away. Sydney may be the only option. Damien Ryan, Nine News.